Welcome to another edition of When Will It Burst? A little fun while we learn about fluid systems. A common practice in fluid systems in many industries is the use of rubber hose with push-on hose end connections and hose clamps, because it is often a cost-effective solution for many lower pressure and less critical applications. Swagelok's PB series rubber hose is a great choice for general purpose applications, including compressed air, water cooling, and oil transfer. A benefit of using Swagelok PB series hose is it is manufactured with an internal fiber reinforcement that enhances its pressure rating, helps promote flexibility, and ensures connection retention. Swagelok PB series hose and Swagelok PB push-on hose end connections have been specifically designed to be used together without hose clamps. This will alleviate any concern you may have over possible exterior or interior hose damage or leakage that could be caused by the use of hose clamps, and it removes the extra time and expense added by the use of unnecessary hose clamps. We do not recommend using other manufacturers' push-on hose end connections with Swagelok PB series hose. We cannot guarantee that their designs, choice of materials, or manufacturing tolerances will result in the same robust performance you can rely on with Swagelok PB series hose and Swagelok PB hose end connections. In today's video, we will be bursting 3/8 inch Swagelok PB series hose installed with Swagelok PB hose end connections. According to the Swagelok Hose and Flexible Tubing Catalog, this hose has a working pressure of 300 PSIG and a minimum burst pressure of 1200 PSIG. Now that you have that important information, you're ready to guess, when will it burst? Please put your best guess in the comment section below this video, blog, or social media post. And in the next video, we will reveal the actual burst pressure and the winner, along with another edition of When Will It Burst?